Hi friends, so next question for essay point of view, so that is nothing but there is a previous question that is in 2019 paper. The question is given in the fifth, so that can be represented in the fifth unit actually, 10 years. So explain the variable threshold CMOS inverter circuit with a neat sketch, and part B vachesi what are the advantages and disadvantages of a MT CMOS circuit. So first let us see what is meant by VT. So VT CMOS is nothing but variable threshold CMOS circuits. Okay, variable threshold CMOS circuit. So the main thing of the VT CMOS is nothing but low supply voltage along with the low threshold voltage provides a reduced overall power dissipation without degrading the performance. So the main concept is nothing but with the help of a VT CMOS is nothing but we have to reduce the power dissipation as well as we have to maintain the performance of the circuit without affecting the remaining parameters. So that is the main concern. So here, however, the use of the low threshold voltages transistors leads to the increase in the sub-threshold leakage current, which is of the major concern when the circuit is in the standby mode. So main problem is nothing but if you are reducing the supply voltage, obviously threshold voltage also reduces. As the threshold voltage is decreases, the sub-threshold leakage is increases due to the internal capacitances across the source and drain regions. So that is the main problem actually. So when the circuit is in the standby mode, these sub-threshold leakage currents leads to the maximum power dissipation in the corresponding circuit. So for that purpose we have to focus here. So like if you go for the maximum, most of the handheld batteries like mobile phones, tabs, all are operated with the battery actually. So all these devices are in a maximum case in the standby mode. In the standby mode, if the leakage power dissipation is maximum, obviously the battery life of the corresponding devices decreases. So that is also, so for that purpose this variable threshold CMOS circuit is use of a body effect to reduce the sub threshold leakage current. So body effect means that the corresponding source is connected to the substrate is connected to the source with the help of, as well as substrate is also connected to the drain with the help of by applying the different voltages across the source and drain, we can control the corresponding substrate voltage. So that leads to change in the corresponding threshold voltage also. That is one of the technique actually. But if you go for the VT CMOS point of view, we will use some another technique that is generally nothing but by using some separate circuit. So the threshold voltage is a function of voltage difference between the source and substrate. Okay, generally threshold voltage means that it is a difference of voltage in between the source and substrate actually. As well as the substrate terminals of a N channel and is connected to the ground, as well as P channel is connected to the VDD supply. Therefore, the corresponding two substrates or corresponding regions are in opposite to, obviously the source and drain diffusions are regions are always remains in the reverse bias region with respect to the substrate. Therefore, these threshold voltage of the transistors are not influenced by the body effect. Okay, not influenced by the body effect whenever you are connected like this. So on the other hand, in case of the VT CMOS circuit, the substrate bias voltages of the NMOS and PMOS transistors can be controlled with the help of some substrate bias control circuit. Okay, this is generally physical structure of the CMOS circuit actually. The general structure of the CMOS circuit. So this is nothing but with the help of a corresponding circuit is nothing but with the body bias and the complementary metal oxide semiconductor. So this is a just a representation, but this is a traditional way. But if you go for the VT CMOS point of view, so this is just a circuit diagram for that one. So here NMOS and PMOS transistor substrates are connected to the one separate control unit that is generally called as a substrate bias control unit. These substrate bias control unit is focusing is used to control the biasing voltages of the NMOS transistor as well as the PMOS transistor. So the main thing is nothing but whenever the circuit is in the standby mode, at that time we have to increase the threshold voltage. Okay, we have to increase the threshold. If you are increasing the threshold voltage, obviously the sub-threshold leakage current is reduced by the 4 times. Okay, that is the maximum concept behind this one. So for that purpose, they can explain some theoretical point of view. When the circuit is operating in the active mode, the substrate bias voltages for NMOS and PMOS transistors are VBN is equal 0 for NMOS and VBP is equal VDD respectively. Assuming that when the VDD is equal 1 for NMOS transistor, as well as for VTH is equal generally 0.2 voltage and VTP is equal minus 0.2 volts respectively. So on the other hand, when the circuit is in the standby mode, the substrate bias control generates a lower substrate bias voltage, that is nothing VB for NMOS, and a higher substrate voltage for VB is equal VDD plus VB for a PMOS. Therefore, this leads to increase in the threshold voltage for NMOS and PMOS transistor. So that means main thing is nothing but whenever the circuit is in the standby mode, at that time with the help of these VT CMOS circuit, we have to increase the threshold voltage. Whenever we are increasing the threshold voltage, obviously what happens is that the threshold voltage, sub-threshold leakage current is decreases. So it is found that theoretically every 100 millivolts increase in the threshold voltage, the sub-threshold leakage current is reduced by half actually. Okay, if you are increasing the 100 millivolts increase in the sub-threshold voltage, obviously the sub-threshold leakage current threshold voltage is reduced by the half. Although the VT CMOS techniques is very effective technique for controlling the threshold voltage and reducing the sub-threshold leakage current, it requires a twin well or triple well CMOS fabrication technology, so that the different substrate bias voltages can be applied to the different parts of the chip. Therefore, separate power pins may also be required, the substrate biasing controlling of all those things. So usually additional area is required for this substrate bias control circuitry is negligible compared to the overall chip. So in case of the VT CMOS low, we need a extra circuitry. But if you go for the area is also one of the important point of view. But if this the corresponding substrate control unit is very negligible compared to the size of the corresponding chip also. So this is a 5 mask question is in 2019 actually. So variable threshold voltage ante em ledante just manam substrate use chesukoni we can control the body bias actually. So ikkada VT CMOS lo em chestunnarante NMOS and PMOS lo unde substrate terminals extract chesi aa two terminals is connected to the one separate device ki connect chestunna danne ikkada manam sub threshold substrate bias control unit ani cheptunnam. The main function of this substrate bias control vachesi eppudaithe circuit ane standby mode lo untundo appudu threshold voltage ni increase cheyali. Threshold voltage increase chese em avutundo obviously sub threshold leakage current decrease avutundi. Circuit anedi on condition lo undante at that time we have to reduce the threshold voltage. So therefore it power dissipation is also decreases because of endukante threshold voltage again increase chesamante it requires a maximum amount of supply voltage required for operation of the corresponding device in the on condition. Okay, so for that purpose in the on condition we have to reduce the threshold voltage, in the half condition or standby mode we have to increase the threshold voltage. So that is the main consideration actually. So second part is in the corresponding thing is nothing but what are the advantages and disadvantages of MT CMOS. But here I am not mentioned that one actually. So answer for that one is nothing but MT CMOS advantages point of view. The main advantage of MT CMOS is that it can be easily implemented using existing circuits without modification of the cell library. The main advantages of MT CMOS circuit vachesi it can be easily implemented using existing circuits without modification of the cell library. So some of the problems are overcome in the dual VT approach presented in the following section. But coming to the disadvantages point of view, MT CMOS is also having some of the disadvantages. That is nothing but it suffers from the when the circuit is in the standby mode, that is the power is reduced. Moreover, large inserted sleep transistor increases the both area and delay. So disadvantages are area and delay are two important things for disadvantages. But if you go for the advantages point of view, MT CMOS does not require any extra circuitry. With the existing circuitry it can be implemented. So there is a 10 marks regarding the corresponding 5th unit actually, right? So I think I hope I covered very quickly actually in the unit 5. This is the 10A and 10B answer for this one. Okay, so thank you guys for watching. In case if you like the video, you can share with your friends if they really need actually. Okay, thank you for